Hello everyone, welcome to the virtual practical class of Manocha Academy. In today's class, we are going to see the different parts of a compound microscope, and we are also going to talk about how the different parts work. Now, this is a typical compound light microscope. Why is it called a light microscope? It is called a light microscope because we use a source of light to illuminate the specimen that we are trying to see. So in this microscope, we will use LED light. However, you can also use natural or artificial light to light up or illuminate the specimen. Why is it called a compound microscope? It is known as a compound microscope because in this microscope, we use two different lenses with different magnifications so that your final image has a much larger magnification. So let us see what are the different parts and how they help in observing specimens. So the first part of the microscope that you see here is this region, which is known as the foot. The foot is the base on which this entire microscope is standing. Here, this arched part is known as the arm, and the arm is holding this body to which two types of lenses are attached. The first lens that is attached to the body is this lens, which is known as the eyepiece lens. If you see closely, the eyepiece lens has a certain magnification, which here is written as 25x. You may have an eyepiece lens which is 10x, that is, magnifies the image 10 times. You may also have an eyepiece lens which is 15x, which is magnifying an image 15 times. At the base of the body, we have this rotatable disc which is known as the nose piece. The nose piece in this microscope has three lenses attached, and these lenses are known as objective lenses. If you look closely, you will see that all these three lenses have different degrees of magnification mentioned on them. The lowest power here is usually 10 times, that is 10x, and the highest power is usually 40x, 45x or 65x. Here we have three magnifications for the objective lens: 10x, which is low power, 45x, which is higher than 10x, and 100x, which is the highest power in this microscope. Then you have this stage. This metallic stage is the base on which we will keep our specimen. And this base has been provided with clips, which will help us to hold the slide in position. The source of light in this microscope is the LED bulb that we are using here. However, you might have seen a microscope in the laboratory where a mirror is usually used. This mirror that we use is a plano-concave mirror, which means that one side of the mirror is plane, that is straight, and the other side is concave. The concave mirror, as you must be knowing, is responsible for collecting light from different directions and focusing it to one point. So we use this mirror and we attach it here to the base of the microscope so that the mirror can collect light from different directions and send it into the specimen or onto the specimen. If you want to adjust the amount of light entering, let's say the field, the microscopic field, is appearing too bright, you might want to reduce the amount of light. In that case, we have a diaphragm here, which you can rotate to adjust the amount of light entering and leaving. This diaphragm is almost like the iris of your eye. So with the iris, just like you decrease or increase the diameter of your pupil, you can do that same thing with this diaphragm. Now we have to bring the specimen to the focus of these two lenses. You must be aware that if you have a camera with which you are focusing something which is right in front of you, you cannot use that same camera to focus something which is far away. This I'm talking about the DSLR camera. So in that case, what do you have to do? After focusing on the object which is near you, you can focus on another object which is further away, but you have to bring that object into the focus of the camera. So similarly here, whenever you are putting a specimen on the stage, you have to adjust so that the image is at the focus. The specimen is at the focus. All right. So how do we do that? For that, we have these two screws. The first one, which is this large one, is known as the coarse adjustment screw. If you see this one, and if you just rotate this one, you can clearly see that the body is moving up and down along with the lenses. This increases or decreases the gap between the stage and the lens, objective lens. And that helps in bringing the image in focus. Now, we all have different powers in our natural eye lens. If you wear a specs, you have a different power. I have a different power, and that is why even after I focus the object with the help of this coarse adjustment screw, it may so happen that it is exactly focused for my eye lens, but it is not for yours because you have a different power. So in that case, you might want to make fine adjustments, but you do not want to completely move the body up and down. In that case, we have this one, which is known as the fine adjustment screw, with which, see, if when I'm rotating the fine adjustment screw, there is no movement of the body. So it is basically adjusting the lens very minutely without moving the entire body. And with this, you can bring the specimen to your own focus, right? Now, we will show you a slide. So this is a glass slide on which generally we put a specimen which we need to observe under the microscope, and so that your specimen does not fly away, it does not dry out, it is not damaged, we usually cover the specimen with a cover slip. You can see this is an absolutely fine piece of glass which we use to cover and save the specimen from being damaged. Now, once you have prepared your slides, sometimes we have prepared slides. For example, we have a large number of prepared slides here. I will show you one of them. So this slide is of the algae Spirogyra. As you can see, there is a cover slip here. In this case, the cover slip is round, but you may also have square cover slips like this, right? So this is a permanent slide which has already been prepared, and this will stay for a very long time. It will not get damaged because it has been preserved that way. So now what we'll do is we will take this slide and we will place it on the stage and secure the position of the slide with the help of the clip. Now with this, you have the slide on the stage. On the stage, there is a small aperture through which the light will enter and it will fall on the specimen. That is all right, but you might have to move the slide right, left, forward or backwards. For that, you have usually this kind of a screw attached to your microscope. Certain compound microscopes may not have this screw. In that case, you have to manually move the slide. However, if you are provided with these screws, as you can see, we can move the screws and move the slides right and left, backwards or forward. Now, once we have brought the slide and the specimen right in the same line as the lenses, we can start using the coarse adjustment screw to focus. Now, at this point of time, I'm using 100x for the objective lens and 25x for the eyepiece lens. So if I'm using 100x and 25x, then first the specimen is magnified 100 times, and then that 100 times magnified image is magnified another 25 times. So you are getting overall a magnification of 2500 times of the actual size of the specimen that you see here. So how do we observe it? We will have to place our eye on the eyepiece lens and make sure that the mirror is collecting enough light and focusing it on the specimen So when you do that, you will see that your entire field that you can see under the microscope is lighted up, is illuminated. It is not dark, it is not black, it is illuminated. So when you move the mirror will be able to collect light from natural sources or artificial sources. You can do this in front of a light which is artificial, or you can do it in front of a window through which sunlight is coming in, right? So then you start adjusting your focus by moving the coarse adjustment screw. And while you are doing that, you can move your slide right or left so that you can bring the specimen right beneath the objective lens. And now I can see a very distinct view of the algae Spirogyra under my microscope. So this is how the specimen looks under the microscope in high power and in low power. Hope you enjoyed today's session. We will come back with more practical classes from Manocha Academy. Take care. Thank you. Subscribe to our channel and go to our website www.manochaacademy.com for courses on physics, chemistry, biology, mathematics, and computer coding. Hope you will have fun. Happy learning.